Hey everyone, welcome back to Regrowth episode number 23 with Sabri! Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Payback!
Payback for
pay
what? I didn't
back.
Do anything!
You did everything!
I didn't do anything!
Jesus, taking a lot to kill you.
I know, I really am. Oh, I'm withered.
Armor piercing. Ooh, your grave is red.
Ooh.
I'm keeping it.
No, I'm going to tell you right now, I have a really, really good score. 12,627. I have to say I did pretty darn good.
Guess so.
Too bad. So we've been doing a lot of stuff and things since last episode.
Yes.
Mainly
have.
With the tree.
Yes.
Take a look. Isn't it so nice? We made some more branches. We even built off a new area, which we're going to be working on today a little bit.
Yes.
So,
little spoiler there.
Did you get your revenge back yet?
No, I think I might need a little bit more revenge.
Oh, there it is. I was
no, nothing.
So, I didn't see anything.
Me either.
Unfortunately, what? That's not helpful whatsoever. Is that for the second time I've killed
that
you?
That might be for the second time.
Are we caught up now?
It might be. No.
We're
I'm pretty
not?
Sure you killed. Not to mention all the times you accidentally killed me off camera.
Okay, those don't even count. That's not even
they
fair.
They do count. They
no,
count.
It doesn't.
They count on my heart. They hurt my feelings.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I do.
We're going to have to get like a cleaver or something at some point because I don't see one.
I don't either.
So we'll just do it a little bit later. I don't know. We were trying to see if I could get a head drop.
It was a fun way for me
to try. Our witchery altar. We thought it might be kind of cool. So
maybe you can get one off of me. Maybe my head's like not as attached as yours or something. I don't know. I even tried killing you with my bow and
I'm not going to take the slack for killing you on
hey,
camera.
Hey, why not?
Because people are already mad at me for killing you enough already.
But isn't my head pretty? Don't you just want to look at
it
all the time?
I don't want to like sit there and look at it on an altar where I'm going to perform sacrifices and
such.
There's no buts about it.
Please. Try. Please, come on. Come on. Do it. Do it.
Really?
Do it. Do it. I want to see my fairies attack you. Oh, no fair. You can't attack the fairies.
Too bad.
Okay.
You have died by the hand of the Boreas.
Whoa.
Boreas. I'm just going to place my... Oh, man, I can't place the gravestones back down. That's poo.
No, I don't think you can.
That's lots of poo. You know what? I don't even want them then. Get out of my inventory, poo.
That's what I would do. Ooh, mine's gold.
Oh, yours is gold. Here, I'm going to make sure I hold shift so I don't pick up all your stuff from like 1,000 meters away.
Yeah.
Just give a second. There you go.
Nope. No
drop. No head. Okay, we'll have to do something about that. I'm not sure what's going on.
Yeah.
It's like poop.
We
poop.
Could just be... What?
Those gravestones are poop. I don't want them.
I thought you said something else. I was like, what?
So we're going to do a little bit of work in Witchery. We've already done some building, and we've made an area for us to start setting up a little bit of Witchery. We've moved some of the stuff we had down here already, like the big stuff, like the chests already.
Yeah.
And we're going to move some more of that here in just a minute.
That
also,
was just boring.
I want to show them also what I did down here. Aw. So let me just go ahead and fly to demonstrate. So I have on these two dispersive... augments on these far end sparks here, so you can see this is a Gaia mana spreader. This thing pumps out mana like crazy, even faster than I believe the Elven. And I even added a velocity and potency lens on there to make it even faster. So it pretty much pulls from these two mana pools to these Gaia mana spreaders to these two mana pools that disperse.
You can put them on the grass.
Yeah, I figured you could put them on dirt.
That's what I was thinking.
I don't want them in here.
Hey, whatever. I'll keep it there.
Yeah, you can keep yours there. Yeah. So now that we, anytime we come in here, we can just refill our mana tablets just by walking in here, and
just
it's
by being
really
in the
nice.
Area. Yeah.
So
I like it.
Well, let's get to work. Let's do some witchery, sweetie.
Yes.
Oh.
Been excited. Been wanting to do.
I
some
have to
more
show
witchery.
Them.
Oh, yeah.
The farm.
It's very OCD friendly now.
I have.
And it's very nice looking.
Well, except for the sprinklers. I'm still going to work on those. I haven't done that yet.
Yeah, that's a work in progress.
For the most part, I have redone the entire farm. We've been working on getting a lot of the things up to like 10-10-10. We're close to. Fred likes to dance on top of the roof and follow you.
Fred wants to give me hugs.
So we got bunch of fire seeds, the water, everything kind of more organized as well. I'm trying to keep like the metals on this side here.
Yep.
More valuable items over here, like the diamonds, lapis, redstone, coal. I got obsidian over here. Back here we have infused shards, ender pearls, skeleton. Like, so here's like mobs. These are the two that we want there.
Yeah. We didn't really care for creepers and withers, but if they might have noticed our new additions over here. I worked on getting us the osmium, ardite, and cobalt.
Oh, yeah.
In hopes of it opening something like Certus quartz, because we need Certus essence. But
we were reading your comments and we saw that you guys were telling us that
it's in the new update pretty much.
Well, we say update, but it hasn't even been released as far as I've seen, so.
Yeah. Well, at least not on Feed the Beast.
I don't know. I have not seen an update anywhere, so.
Yeah.
I know it's been a long time coming, and it's been a long time since the last update, so I don't know if it's going to come. If not, anything, so.
At least by the time that we finish our series.
Yeah.
Hopefully it is, but.
We're going to try to work towards it, but in the meantime, let's go ahead and start picking this up. A couple of you guys actually mentioned that we could possibly get into bee breeding.
Mm-hmm.
And we could maybe get some Certus quartz that way. I think it might take us a little while to do that, but it's still better than nothing.
And you're picking up everything. Whatever.
You know what? I'll just be your inventory.
Yeah, you might as well. I mean, that's kind
of... Do you not use your magnet?
No, I don't like it. Because, I mean, when I'm trying to, like, do other things, it just gets in the way.
Oh, okay.
But I do occasionally, but I don't typically need it for what I've been doing, so.
Right. Well, I'm going to pick up the ember moss.
Okay.
With some shears. And we don't really need all of this, but we do want a good variety of stuff. Wow, Fred.
Goodness, Fred. Jeez,
Fred, calm down, guy. I'm not sure. I don't think we can pick this up with shears. I don't think that's... Yeah.
What?
I think
the pumpkin. The melon, yeah. I probably could have silk touched it.
Yeah, I think you can.
So.
I'm on fire.
I'll go ahead and get those if you get everything else.
Here, I'm going to grab some of these.
Fire.
You too, huh?
Yes.
Wow. We're just wow. All right, let's see. Let's get some Spanish moss. Spanish moss is good.
Spanish moss does look nice.
Spanish
looks
amazing.
I like
the
way it's
doing.
Forest. Exactly. That's what I was going to say. I love that color.
It looks so good.
Should I pick up some of these flowers?
Huh?
Should I pick up some of these flowers?
Yes. Lots.
Because they're pretty. And I want some in the tree.
Picks up all the flowers. We need a lot of flowers.
It's
we probably need more
flowers
than what we actually had over there.
Yeah.
We got a whole chest of them over here. And we'll probably wind up using those as well.
Yeah, just filling up the area. Okay, I think I'm full on stuffs. Let's go.
Yeah, we'll pick up some more stuff here in a bit, but we want to try to get as much altar power as we possibly can.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. I'm looking for some bones and bone meal. There we go.
Bro, they're in the chest thing. That. What?
Yeah, I got them. Oh, I see you upgraded us to obsidian and the diamond size down here.
That I did.
Of course, it still doesn't solve our inventory problems, but we'll try to get to that soon once we get to plant logistics.
Yeah. It's better than it was. What?
I'm going to show them what we've been working on up here. I haven't even showed them the new witchery area.
Oh, yeah.
So here's our skysmith.
Oh, yeah. We decided to call it the skysmith.
It's actually not a bad name. I kind of like it, the skysmith. It reminds me of something from Elder Scrolls almost. Wink, wink. Nudge,
yeah. Kind of like a knockoff.
But here it is. This is our witchery area.
It's fancy.
Mm-hmm. There's this metamorphic brick from Batania, and this stuff is really, really nice. I haven't really showed them how to get that yet.
I thought we did.
I don't think we did. I think we kind of forgot. But just in case, we'll refresh memories.
Yeah.
What's it called? It's called Morph or something?
Mighty
Morphin Power Rangers? That thing, yeah. The metamorphosis. Solid as a rock. And it's not actually very hard to craft at all in the Petal Apothecary. It really doesn't require any top-tier runes at all. Just the basic runes, some basic petals, and a redstone root. And if you lay this down, it barely uses any mana next to a mana pool and just converts to a whole bunch of different of this metamorphic rock. And it looks amazing.
It does. We really are enjoying these stone bricks of them.
Oh, yeah. So we got a whole big area down here. We just start planting stuff, sweetie.
Do you want me to put the altar here?
No, the altar goes actually upstairs where the green is. This is just to kind of map where it is above us.
Okay. Well, I'll leave that up to you. Or you can just, like, map out where you want it up here. Oh, you already did.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
Do you want it on top of this brick, or...
No, yeah, just replace the brick with it. Okay. And then I'm going to do a little bit of bone meal here and there. Maybe a little bit of everywhere. Ooh, look at all the pretties.
All the pretties.
Oh, you're going to like this. Butter. Oh, you're going to like this a lot. Look at that. That looks good.
How do I put the stuff on there?
Right click it on there.
It's not right clicking on there.
Right click harder.
It's not going on there. It's not working.
Okay. Let me see. Throw me some stuff.
That's what won't go on there.
Okay. It looks like there's durability? A little bit of damage taken on it.
Okay.
That's probably that have what the problem to do with is. It? I can't even figure out how to craft it because of the stupid mana tablets. There we go. Yeah, we'll have to make another one.
Okay. Well, I got everything else up there anyway.
Okay. If you want to make us one real quick, that'd be awesome. I'm just going to finish...
what was it called?
The Arthana. It's a very cool name. A-R-T-H-A-N-A.
I know how to spell it.
Yay!
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's super easy to make. That's cool. Oh, yeah, I need to put my flowers down here. I got a bunch of random stuff.
I'm going to throw some of this... Oh, yes. Spanish moss in this area. So we figured we'd do a little bit of the decorating on camera, too, because building is nice sometimes, right?
Yeah, and some people like to see that. And
some people like to
see that. For the people who don't, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we are apologetic to you guys. Very much so. Gotta have our smiley pumpkins.
We're trying to make it as little painful as possible.
Yes. Yes, we are. We're trying to prepare.
That's even a thing.
I'm going to head down and actually grab a few other things as well.
Okay.
I'm thinking... Ooh, the Batania flowers are nice.
Mm-hmm.
Do that. Maybe you. And you. I don't think we have any of those.
Hey, my cute little happy pumpkin's cute.
I love that cute pumpkin. Little happy pumpkin. There's a lot cute. Of people, I think, that like that pumpkin as well.
It's adorable. I mean, you just can't. He's you can't cute be little mad fella. At a face like that.
You
just
see a face like that, and it makes you smile.
Exactly.
Oh, guess what happened, sweetie?
What happened?
Your other silverwood tree grew.
Oh, and it has. Yay! The water changed too. That's what I was hoping.
Yeah, guys. That water looks awesome down there.
If you're wondering why I kept so intently planting that one there, that's why. Oh my gosh, why did you plant these ember mosses everywhere?
Oh wow, I did, didn't I? I just ran over
one. I've been running over them constantly.
Oh man.
It's just like, why would you do that?
So many pretty flowers.
So much fire.
Mystical beautifulness.
Such burn.
So I did a little bit of reading on the altar, and the altar has about a 15-block radius from where it's at.
Uh-huh.
So this is doing not bad, but it's not doing great at all.
It's not doing not bad, but it's not doing great at all.
It's really not.
That makes so much sense.
We had 7,000 down there.
Yeah, I know.
So
I didn't figure all these little flowers would do too much.
Yeah, we
versus like how many trees do we have out here? 5, including the one, not including our big tree that we live in. But I don't think that really counts for some reason.
We definitely are gonna have to do some more. So I'm gonna set up like the spinning wheel right there. I'm gonna maybe set up right here next to our altar. I don't know if I really like that sitting right there. The witch's oven.
Oh yeah.
Maybe I'll set it up over here against the wall. I don't know. We'll play around with it, but this should still be fairly close enough. If not, the Arthana, I read.
Mm-hmm.
The Arthana actually doubles the length of how far the altar can affect like the things like the witch's oven and the spinning wheel and stuff like that. So,
oh, okay.
That's well, really nice to know.
I just put it back down, by the way, if you didn't notice.
Oh, the Arthana?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. All right, so I think what we're going to need to do, sweetie, is get a whole bunch of different trees and stuff. We're going to have to increase our altar power even more.
Mm-hmm. Where are we going to put the trees, though?
I'll show you guys. I'll show
ow,
everyone.
Oh, fire. Why do you put ember mosses in my walkway?
I don't know, but we'll come back in a minute. We're going to do a little bit of work off camera to get some more altar power going, and we'll show you guys the results of that in just a minute. So we'll be back in just a second. And we're back.
Yay.
Yes.
Yes.
We've done stuff.
We did stuffs.
We've been trying to test around with the altar power a little bit, and so far we've come to kind of the conclusion that I'm not going to say this is the truth or not, but it just seemed to work better. Things that are on the same level as the altar and that have, like, direct access to it, open air. You can see the particle effects even going to the altar on this level. I stand down here and I look and I don't see any particle effects.
Or maybe it just doesn't get particle effects because it's on a different level.
Maybe, but, I mean, it does affect it. We've seen it actually affect the altar by placing and removing stuff down here.
Mm-hmm.
It's not as drastic as when we started planting a whole bunch of different trees up here, so.
But it also could be the trees up here that's making it do that drastic change.
Yeah, I don't...
That's what my theory is on it, but... Either one of us could be
wrong. I'm sure everyone's going to correct us in the comments, so that's fine.
Yeah.
Anyway, I want to set us up an infinite water source, and I haven't showed people how to make this abyssal stone yet.
Something I figured out for you, because you were like, oh, this is completely useless, and I'm like, abyssal stone, you're
like,
say what?
Well, I was
like,
I don't think we really need water essence, and she's like, well, you can make abyssal stone, and I'm like, oh, okay,
never mind.
We'll just go ahead and grow some essence of water then. So I've been using the abyssal stone up here, and I like it. So
like
you
it
asked
too.
Me where we should place our cauldron.
Kettle.
That thing.
And cauldron, I guess, but
works too.
I just have a random kettle on me, so I'm like, where do you want to put it?
Maybe over here in this area, like this. So what I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to set something kind of cool up.
Kind of cool.
I like this.
The tree's in the way.
No, it's not. The tree is happy.
Oh, is this... I'll be quiet. I'm be quiet.
Yes.
Because I want to see it in its...
In its full glory.
Yes.
All right, so that one's set up right there just fine. And then I'm going to place this guy here.
Okay.
And I'm going to do this. Actually, I missed one.
You did.
There we go. You happy now?
Very happy.
Very much happy?
Mm-hmm.
All that
much
happy.
Better.
All right, and there we go. And if you guys haven't figured it out yet, this is going to be our infinite water source of poo water.
Yeah, we need to change that.
We'll work on that.
You could have put it over one of the little corners that had a little bit of green.
So check it out. Look at that. So if we just come up here now, we just right click. Whoa.
And not doing right?
Huh.
What's wrong?
The carpenter's wedge slope in the back kind of makes it do a little derpiness. So if I like come up here and right click, it's like I'm trying to click on the wedge slope, so I'm thinking... I think what I'm going to do is we're going to break this fella here. Uh-oh. Oh, there it goes. Nice.
Okay, that works.
It doesn't look too bad, right?
This tree kind of eyesore to me.
It is the amaranth. I like amaranth.
Well, no. I mean, like, for the structure. I love the amaranth tree. Well, I don't really like the way they look, but I like the wood inside.
Right.
But.
Excuse me.
I'm just like, but.
I want to put our kettles right here like this.
You have a spider somewhere?
Yeah. He's downstairs. I figured our kettles would look kind of cool like this.
Why is there three spots for him, though?
Because you can put yours right there.
But what about in the middle?
Nothing. That's where we walk to go ahead and put...
I was thinking, like, there could be, like, three... I don't know. I don't know what I'm thinking.
Now, the only problem with this is going to be that I can see already is fire bad?
Yeah, fire is bad.
But we'll work through that a little bit later. I'm just going to go ahead and place down your netherrack.
Really?
What? What's wrong?
You didn't see me hitting the spider?
And
you just decided to jump down in front of my sword?
I was fixing your cauldron. It looks nice.
It does look nice, though. It does look much better.
We still have the witch's cauldron to place down. I'm just going to pop it down over here in the corner. I don't think we're really going to need it right now. Let's get to some witchery.
Witchery.
And let's take a look. I believe it's down in how the world changes. Let's chalk it up. We need to, the coven witches you've spoken to, which we haven't spoken to any, made the suggestion that you should learn the art of circle magic. A key component of these circles are runes written in a special ritual chalk. You can craft the most basic ritual chalk from gypsum, which can be distilled from quicklime.
Ooh.
Let's type in chalk. Let's see what we can actually make here. So we got this, I don't want planting chalk. All right, so we need gypsum. Foul fume and quicklime. All right, so we got our witch's oven. And
do we have our wood ash up here? I think I did put it back in there. I should have.
Yeah,
I did. Okay.
All right, so we got... So I have the quick lime. We need some foul fume, which I have plenty of.
Actually,
as well.
We have 8 gypsum in here.
Okay, we have 8 gypsum in here.
It's beside the... Yeah.
There it is. I'm going to make a couple of these.
Yeah.
And then we need some tears of the goddess, which are hiding from me. We don't have tears of the goddess.
Yeah, no, we don't.
You're kidding me.
Yep, we don't have any tears.
We have breath of the goddess. All right, that'll work. I need a little bit of lapis. Could you get me some lapis?
This sucks because I have to go all the way to the bottom of the tree.
I know.
And then go all the way back up, which takes forever to fly up.
It's okay. I hope we'll be able to remedy that at some point soon.
I'm just going
to
bring a stack of it. Is there anything else we need that's like witchery-like that we use a lot?
Let me take a look-see real quick. I don't think we're going to be doing Bane of Tibbs anytime soon. And holding on, I really don't care to do. So maybe the Brew of the Fouling Spirit? I don't know. We'll see. Besides that, I don't really see anything else we need.
I was about to say, resource-wise, is there anything?
Yeah, not really seeing anything.
I'll bring some glass for, like my water bottles and stuff, I guess.
This looks cool. It just stinks, because I really didn't want to have to put trees up here, because trees on top of a tree?
Yeah, it's kind of awkward looking, but actually it's not too bad.
I mean, it really doesn't look that bad. I don't know, it kind of does look bad.
It really doesn't. Not from afar. And I mean,
the rest of the tree looks really awesome.
It does.
But anyway,
okay, I got 2 lapis. It's in the tree.
It's in the tree in the chest somewhere. Okay.
In the chest in the tree.
All right, let's get this stuff. Oh, man.
What?
What was I supposed to do?
Tear the goddess.
Hold on a minute. Tear the goddess. Oh, that's a distillery. Not that thing. I was like, what am I doing?
Not that thing.
All right, and then I need some clay jars.
What is this spiritual soothing thing? Anyway, brew clay a jar. Flowing spirit. Oh, so something you gotta brew.
Ah, nice. It's working. The distillery's going, sweetie.
Okay.
It's nice. It's gonna take its time, though, apparently.
I'm sure.
So I'm gonna put all this other junk away. I'm gonna also put our spinning wheel down somewhere. I think maybe over yonder.
I might work on this Brew of the Flowing Spirit while you work on that.
Brew of the Flowing Spirit. What
4 wispy cotton and a spinning wheel, 4 fanciful thread with string and odor of purity.
Okay. Well, while that's distilling, I'll go ahead and read what you're going to work on.
Okay.
The sound of flowing water can be quite relaxing, so why not try to create an even or ever better analog for it through brewing in the kettle? What are you trying to... It's trying to mess my mind here. That's what it's doing.
Okay.
Sure. Unfortunately, to make a liquid that sounds truly soothing, you will need to brew it in the spirit world to truly embrace what it feels like to sleep. Unfortunately, this means establishing a base of operations in the spirit world. That sounds like you might not be able to do this.
Yeah.
To the point where you can undertake brewing... Fortunately, the ores there remained intact during the cataclysm and can still be found underground as some deposits of slate. Once you have the flowing spirit, you can place it near your dream weaver of nightmares to further increase the chance of getting a dream rather than a nightmare.
Well, that's nice.
With the dream weaver, 2 blocks of flowing spirit and 2 wispy cotton nearby, you'll have a 100% chance of entering a dream rather... than a nightmare.
Ooh.
So. Ooh, Tears That's of the Goddess. Cool. Yes. Okay.
This brew is actually not that hard to make. The only thing that takes time to make is the fanciful thread.
Mm.
But that takes, like, a minute. Not even that. Not even a minute.
Darn it. What? I don't even know why I unchecked that. We need golden chalk now, so we do need our witch's cauldron.
Oh.
It's like darn you.
Yeah.
All right, so I need a mandrake root, and I need to get this thing up and running. This Ouija's cauldron. You know what? Actually, this is perfect. This is perfect. I'm gonna put it right here in between.
We don't have flint and steel, do we, to light that fire?
Yeah, I do.
You do? Okay, yeah, can you light it, please? Thank you.
You'll have to use this one on the right side.
Why?
Because I took the one off the left side. I need it for my cauldron.
What do you mean you took the one off the left side?
Took the one off the left side. There's no netherrack down there.
There was.
Yeah, needed. Ah, fire,
why,
hurt.
Why didn't you just take that one? I already had my water in here and everything.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't even look at that.
Obviously.
There we go.
Okay. Right.
Now I got my witch's cauldron up and going. And our trees are going to burn down in a moment, which is fine. Oh, there they go.
Wow. Yeah, that's totally fine. Totally fine. Totally cool.
You know what? Let them burn. Don't care. All right, there we go. A little bit of water later. Wait, seriously? What is going on?
Are you picking up my stuff?
Really?
Yes, really. See, that's why I didn't wear my magnet, because I picked up your stuff. Like, you're picking up my stuff. See, I'm throwing it on this.
There you go.
Wow.
Sorry. Okay, back to everything else in our trees burning down. Our entire tree's burning down. I can see that happening.
Are you sure you gave me everything back?
What else? I don't know. My inventory's full. What else would you need?
Never mind. I just got to do it again anyway. Okay. I thought I had everything in there, and I tried to grab it, and it didn't do. So.
Oh.
Hopefully we have more wool of bat, because that took our only one out of here.
Uh-oh.
Yeah,
actually, I think we have wool of bat in the top chest downstairs.
Downstairs. Gotta go back downstairs.
Let's see, we need mandrake root, gold, and then the ritual chalk. Okay, it's brewing up. The trees are burning down. Our altar has not actually lost any power. Actually, I think it's gone up since the trees have been burning.
Nice. Maybe it likes fire.
I think it likes fire. Sweet. Claimed reward. We have woe.
We have woe?
All of the woe.
Did it unlock stuffs? Holy.
Charge. I don't know why, but when I open up my quest
laggy.
Book, it massively starts to lag.
That's what just happened to me too.
And I also, we've had a couple server crashes this evening.
Yeah.
Actually, our client crashing.
Yeah.
And at the same time, so it's kind of weird. We're not entirely sure what's going on there. It might have something to do with that. I don't really know, but I wouldn't mind making this. I've been trying to make this, the redstone soup.
Uh-huh.
Through brewing, you found a way to infuse yourself with power unlike anything you've had before. The first step is to brew some redstone soup.
Okay.
So I'm going to take a look at that one more time. Okay, so that's my problem, the drop of luck. I'm going to attempt this. We have a lot more altar power than we did before.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if that's going to actually help or not. Let's see. Foci room. A key component of these circles are runes written in a special ritual chalk. Someone mentioned something about running chalk around our altar.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think that might help increase its altar power, I think. That right there looks really cool, that twig.
Yeah.
I want that. I want that.
Just, I want that.
I want that twig. You see that twig?
It's shiny and it's glowy.
I want that shiny twig.
What else did I need down here?
This is the thing I need. All right, so a drop of luck. Mandrake root, nether wart. Mandrake root. Do we have any nether wart in here?
Oh, yeah. Also, I made the Starfield generator.
Oh, yeah.
Finally. I actually made that a few episodes ago, and we just never mentioned it because we forgot.
Yeah.
But, yeah, whoops. But, yeah, that's made. That's been a thing.
Because
people were like, hey, I'm surprised you haven't made that yet. And I'm like, me too.
We're all,
so
yes.
I made it. And
I'm actually glad you made it, because I love the Starfield generator thing.
I do, too. That's why I was really surprised that I didn't make it previously.
And then Mutandus Extremis. I'm hoping this works. Please. Sweetie, cross your fingers with me.
Brew of colored water. Why did I just grab that? Random grab, I guess. Okay. Let's hope this works.
Come on.
Is your magnet on?
No, it's not.
Thank God. Okay.
Mine looks like it's doing stuff. It did it! It did it!
I heard.
Yes!
So much excite.
So excite. Oh, man, that means we can actually make the redstone soup. I think we can actually fill that chalice over there with redstone soup,
mm-hmm.
and it will actually help us out even more, too. So that's
even.
Why do
I have slowness?
It was because we did some witching stuff around the cauldron.
Oh. Why is my thing not working, though? Maybe I don't have enough. I put everything in there.
Did you find any more wool of bat, by the way?
Yeah, I put it in the chest.
Oh, it's in this one up here?
Yeah.
Okay. Do we have a lot? Oh, cool.
Yeah, we had 6, and I used 1.
Let's take a look at yours. What's wrong?
It's not doing...
It's just, and you did everything right?
Yeah, I put everything in there that it said.
Okay, I think it's... We'd have to do exactly what it said. We'll have to probably wind up doing that one in the spirit world.
Mm. Okay.
I thought maybe we could, because we had everything, right?
Yeah, but I guess that's what it is.
Yeah, that would
I guess it kind of makes sense, but at the same time, didn't it say, like, you can't bring stuff in the spirit world?
It says you can't, but it also just mentioned, when I read through it, that you could, there was actually ores in that world still.
Okay, but how would we even do this operation in that world?
You would have to work your way back all the way through everything. I think is what it was getting
at. No, thank
you. Yeah,
if that sounds like what you're making it sound like to me, Nope. Sorry, guys. We're not doing it. I'm just kidding.
Maybe not right now. We'll take a look at it maybe later. We'll see.
Maybe yours is a simpler thing.
What am I missing? I think I'm missing. Redstone, tongue of dog. I got that. Belladonna.
Yeah, it's only in the quest for...
Yeah, Mandrake.
Witchery that makes it lag. Maybe it's all the shiny stuff.
Yeah, it could be all the shiny stuff. So I'm actually about to make this redstone soup if you want to come watch.
Yep, I'll be on my way.
I gotta say, I love this tree.
We probably should have slept through the storm, though.
Ah, it'll be all right.
It's annoying.
It's very annoying. I will agree with you there.
So, yeah.
Much annoy. All right, so this is also done in the kettle. And I need a mandrake root. Which I thought I had grabbed one, but I guess I didn't. Go ahead and refill this guy back up.
It's supposed to be in the cauldron or the kettle?
Actually, you're right. It's in the kettle.
Yeah, because you said kettle and you were about to use the cauldron.
Is yours full?
Yeah, it should be full.
Okay. All right, let's give it a whirl, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so a piece of redstone.
Ooh, that turned it a really pretty color.
Nice. Tongue of dog.
I like that color purple.
Drop of luck.
Ooh, I like that color red. It's my favorite color.
A belladonna. Wool of bats and mandrake root.
There it goes. It's doing pretty stuff.
So I
guess... You didn't even grab bottles.
I didn't even grab a bottle. I think it only gives you one anyway. It does.
Yeah, okay.
We have redstone soup.
Cool.
Oh, that is so awesome.
And we already did the death protection pop-it.
Actually, it gave it to us, so
exactly.
I guess it counted when we opened up the book. I wouldn't mind seeing how to make another one anyway, because we like our death protection pop-its. That was pretty awesome.
Actually, you used yours, too.
Yeah, well, you used yours, too.
I'm pretty sure I did, too, because I've died, but...
It was kind of like a weird situation in both. But now we have an ability to get the drops of luck, so I'm going to work on getting some of those, and we'll make us some more death protection pop-its between this episode and next.
Yeah.
I think
idea.
That'll be perfect.
I agree. Ghost of the Light. Oh, that sounds cool.
Ooh, hold on
Spirit
a second.
Of the Otherwear. It sounds like
how
it said
do we
underwear.
Fill this? Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and fill this real quick, I think.
Infernal
I'm
going to
claim
a
reward because that gives us 3 redstone soup.
Soul of the World. These sound really cool. Soul of the World. Infernal Animus.
Oh my gosh.
What?
Come look at this.
Okay.
And look at our altar power.
It's so nice.
I filled
that up. Wow,
that
did a bunch.
It looks cool, too.
It really does.
Oh, that is so nice. Oh,
I
like this
witchery
stuff.
I love the little effects. I like how many effects, like particle effects, witchery has.
Oh, I do,
on
too.
On its stuff.
Yeah, we're going to have to definitely look in this book, like, after I know.
I wonder if you could have filled that with other things. These
Ooh.
Other...
Oh, my frame rate went up after... Yeah, it's this page, I think,
it
that's
is.
Doing it. Okay.
That's... Yeah.
Ghost of Light. One of the options for infusion is light. With ghost this infusion, you can create barriers and plant form from thin air.
See page 57 of Witchcraft Circle Magic for information on performing the infusion. Only one of these four quests can be completed.
We have to pick one. So you know what we're going to do?
We're going to evaluate.
Between this episode next, me and you are going to pick two separate ones that we want. In the next episode, I think you know what we'll do? We'll go ahead and start working into that.
Wait, we can pick two?
No, we're going to pick two. I'm going to pick one, you're going to pick one.
But we can only do one.
I know.
Like, there can only be one.
Well, I don't know. You might be able to do one, and I might be able to do one. If not, we'll just pick one that we can both
agree
on.
I mean, we might even pick the same one, knowing us. We'd probably pick the same one.
Yeah. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Let us know what you guys think. If you guys have any helpful tips, tricks, or comments, feel free to put them in the comment section down below. If you guys would like the
Look
video.
Look at the stars.
If you guys would like the video. We'd really appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for all of the continued support on the series thus far. You guys have been amazing, as always, and we do appreciate it. We love looking at your comments and your thumbs ups on the videos and everything. So thank you guys again for watching, and until next time, we'll see you guys then.
Goodbye.